Hello everyone, my name is Brian and welcome to another Smite Ranked Duel 1v1. I wanted to do this one because I wanted to play a hunter I haven't played in a very long time, and it's probably, I'm not 100% sure, but it's probably my least played guard in Season 3. And since we are at Season 4 as of the day this video comes out, I figured why not pay tribute to one of those hunters I haven't played too much, and it is going to be Apollo. The bans, I banned, who did I ban? I banned Kali, I didn't want to deal with Kali. I banned Kronos, because Kronos is annoyingly fast, very difficult to hit. And who was the last one I banned? I banned Hoyi, because I don't feel like dealing with an Hoyi. Thinking back to it, I probably should have banned Bakasura, because Bakasura is a very strong 1v1 god as well. I'll take this 1v1. I'll take a little bit more damage with the Butcher Blades, but since I do have my passive, and if I could actually hit it on my basic attacks, that would have been even better. But I can definitely outrate him if we both hit the same amount of basic attacks. He will outclear me a little bit, especially since I don't want to give him too much room. Missing too many basics. He has Hand of the God, so he can go for the red buff basically for free. I can't really contest it. Not only has he gotten his Eat minion, but he also has, of course, his Hand of the God, which are just a bit too powerful to deal with. Also, he is level 4 now, so he has a little bit more power. That means that he has an additional point into his Butcher's Blades. Gives him a little bit passive power, a little bit more damage with his basics. I don't want to tank his minions too much. He will take my blue. Again, I can't really do a lot to it since he also outclears me. If I outclear him, I can contest. I can try to pressure him out. And that way try to, well, get rid of him. He has his ultimate, he's level 5, because he did get both buffs, so I do need to be a little bit careful, he might dive. Something to take into consideration. As you can see, he does a lot of damage, 82 per basic attack. That's actually a lot, since I only do about 50, 58, depending on. Difficult to deal with. His early game is a lot better, because he can just not only have the same amount of clear as I have, but he can also get the buffs basically for free. I'm just going to last hit. I actually think he backed, but he'll lose a little bit of minions. If I push it, he will still get the experience for it. And since I do have a little bit of an experience disadvantage, I'll just do this. I'll just head back. I can ult back, but I feel like I don't really want to yet, because my mana pool is very low and I'll be out of mana basically. I do want to get some additional health potions, because his damage is pretty good. But even though he did get 3 buffs, he's only ahead like 200-300 gold, because I stripped a little bit away by zoning him out. So that is definitely a good thing for us. Jumps over the wall. Nice jump, not gonna lie. Probably should have last hit that big minion. It did lose the gold for it now. But I guess that's fine. I feel like my early game is going to be quite weak against him, because he can farm a little bit better than I can. And as you can see, his basic attacks deal more damage than... Oh, he's definitely going to dive. Maybe I can mess him. Yes, I can mess him. Come on. Sunder! Nice, I got the first blood. That brings me about even with him. Definitely in my favor. I did take a lot of damage. I died to his minions from his ultimate. Can't really do a lot of... I can't really do a lot against that. My blue might be up. I haven't cleared any of them. It's probably not. No, it's not. Okay, red, I doubt it. Maybe. I'm not sure if it's is 4 minutes or 3 minutes. If it's 3 minutes, then it can be up. But still, he can just use his Hand of the God and basically get that one for free. It looks like it is going to be up. So that means that he will be able to get it. I'll just head back. I get my Ikeval. I'll keep my potions and I'll just ult into the lane. Clear the entire wave, because my ultimate can if I get the good placement. As you can see, in the middle, hitting every single minion and basically clearing the entire wave. So that means that I have a good wave advantage. And I can definitely box him here. Come on. Oh, that was a terrible dash. You didn't see that at all. Come on. Nice, he used his jump, he's dead. If I hit, yes. Nice. Another kill. That gives me a little bit of pressure. I think I'll just clear the wave and go to my blue since it just spawned. That will give me the blue guaranteed, as well as get rid of some of the gold and experience he can get from the minions since they do die to the tower. So, yeah, not gonna lie, that was actually pretty good. The fact that I used my ultimate to clear the wave and get there fast was definitely the reason why I was able to kind of pressure him and deal a lot of damage to him. Because he can't fight me and the minion wave simultaneously. Although, I feel like Bakasura is one of those gods that actually has a decent advantage against you if there are minions, since he can heal up from them, and if he finishes off minions, he gets increased movement speed. So that's something that you do want to consider if you leave minions. Especially leaving like one minion will only help him out, because he can just eat them. Excuse me. He will only just eat them, and that will heal him. Make him faster. Make him have more attack speed. So all in all, not a situation you want to be in. I think he's there. Let's just try and zone him out a little bit. I think he'll jump over the blue buff. Yeah, there he is. And as you can see, I get my basic attack. Oh, nice, Thunder! That's actually very good, because that doesn't only mean that he doesn't get this wave, but I'll also be able to do a good amount of damage to this tower, and he will also lose maybe a couple of minions on the next wave. So, oh well, very good. I also have enough gold for my Devourer's Gauntlets, so very good trade for me. That Thunder was definitely... maybe a basic would have been in range, but... I don't know, it slows me down. I wanted to get that one. Not sure if it was a waste of my Thunder, but doesn't care. I don't care. I got the kill. Yeah, not gonna lie. Ooh, I used my mess a little bit too soon there. Why couldn't I dash there? Weird. Decent damage though with the one. Let's see if I can stack up on these minions. You can actually get stacks from minions from other gods. Vulcan turret as well. There are a lot of things you can get stacks from. And I can lifesteal up. He doesn't have any lifesteal. He does have, of course, his eat minion. Red buff is not up yet. Don't think it has been that long. I don't think I'll get the tower. I can't really tank the tower yet. And I'm also quite low on HP. Let's just pop that health potion. I do want to stay in lane. I don't really have anything to get if I back. And since I did clear his entire wave, that gives me an opportunity to go for his tower. But it looks like he has the witch blade. That will be pretty difficult to fight into, because my attack speed is reduced. He'll have the physical protection. Little trick you see me do there. I step back a little bit and I dash through him. That will knock him up. Let's see if he can deal some damage to the Bakasura. Ooh, actually, well played by the Baka. He stays behind the buff, so that means that I can only hit the buff. And my Serenade, he avoided that one perfectly, so wasn't able to deal any damage, and I ended up helping him clearing that buff. And that means that his wave clear is also going to be a little bit faster. But I do have my passive. Looks like he will be going for either his own blue buff or he will back. But that this does give me the opportunity to go for my blue buff. Get that one for free. Get a good amount of experience. And I'll just ult back and... I'll just stay a little bit. I can't really get anything I want. I want to get Witchblade. Same as he has to kind of counter him. Because he also relies a lot on his attack speed. And by reducing his attack speed, I will reduce the overall damage output he can get. I will get enough gold. I'll sell one potion. I don't really need them too much anymore, since I do have the death toll as well. And I use basic attacks mostly to clear the wave. So that's something that Apollo has for him. The downside is that he doesn't get a lot of use out of Bluestone, because he does clear the wave with just basic attacks. So he doesn't really need additional mana you get from the death toll. Ooh, again. Something that I am doing here that's probably not smart. Come on. Let's get some distance from him. I do have my Thunder. Maybe I can kill him. Okay, he will try to avoid my basic attacks. I do still have a good opportunity to kill him. But I do need to make sure that I keep my distance from him. Because if he gets the upper hand, then... I do have my mess now, so I can have a good opportunity to kill him. Mesmerize is very powerful against Bakasura, but if he uses his ultimate, as I use my mess, Even though I do get the protections from my Mesmerize, which provides a little bit of, not a little bit, I think 50 actually, physical protection. Decent damage. It doesn't mess him if I use it immediately as he ults. He has, I think, 1.5 seconds of CC immunity. So if I wait a little bit, I can actually mess him while he is ulting. And that's one of the most powerful counters to the Bakasura. Otherwise, you're definitely in an awkward spot. So I'm actually quite glad I picked the Apollo, because I feel like it's a pretty good counter to the Bakasura, since you do have that Mesmerize available to kind of deter him from going to for you. Also, I have a decent amount of stacks on my Devours. The reason I go for Devours is because he has sustain with his 2. I need to have some form of sustain as well. Let's try to outrun him. Does look like he has Hastened Fatalis. So that's also one of those items. It's quite annoying to fight. And the mess doesn't last as long. Try to juke him out. Oh, that was my bad. I should have basic attacked and waited a little bit longer for my 3 to get up. I tried to move back a little bit to dash through him, but his damage was a little bit too much. I tried to dash through him to knock him up and to give me an opportunity to, well, let him die to the tower. Don't think he would have, but I don't know, I should have just attacked. But the downside, or just the difficulty of fighting him when he has his ultimate, is that those minions will just straight up block me. Looks like he's not going for the Bull Demon King, he's a little bit too low. He went for the red buff, he did get it, but I just cleared a wave. I'm not going to put any more points into my ultimate though. I mainly use it for ult clear, because if I go for him, he will just jump into the air, avoid the ult damage, and jump onto me for that damage and that physical reduction. Or physical protection reduction. So I will level up my 3. It will give more movement speed and it will slow him more if I hit him at the end of it. So I feel like this will help me out a little bit better, since he does have the Hastened, which is quite difficult to fight against, especially if he can just move around in his ultimate to avoid not only my Mesmerize if he stays at max distance, but he can also stay behind his minions from his Regurgitate, which makes it a little bit more difficult because I can't hit through it and my 1 won't kill those minions. So that's quite annoying. I do have an entire minion wave here, so I have a decent advantage if I can actually hit my basic attacks. Let's just use Shell here. Oh, this is what I'm... Come on. Lifesteal? No, no, no. He can just kind of will me back. I can't really go forward because I will just get body blocked by the minions and I'm slowed. And he can still move around those minions. So I do need to get Hastened to kind of get rid of his potential to just outmaneuver me as he goes for the ultimate. I feel like that's my only real opportunity to actually fight him. Because if he goes for his ultimate and his minions body block me, I can't really fight him that well. And it takes me too long to get rid of those minions. Especially since my one is just terrible at clearing anything. So I'll just have to get Hastened and play a little bit passive, at least until, or actually I can go decently aggressive until he has his ultimate backup. But I do need to make sure that he doesn't go for Bull Demon King, because if he gets Bull Demon King, then it will definitely put me in an awkward spot. Looks like he actually might go for it. I'll just clear the wave and check the Bull Demon King. You never know. I'm not sure if his blue is up. I haven't checked it in a long time, actually never. And there he is. Okay, it's fine. Should be fine. I still have my Mesmerize. He doesn't have his ultimate. I'll just get the max duration of the mess so I can get most of the distance. He did use his jump, so... Did he? I think he did, actually. Yeah, he jumped on me to start with. So that gives me the opportunity to just back. Honestly, yeah, I probably should back. He could go... okay, he didn't. That's my bad. I figured he'd go for the Bull Demon King, so I wanted to ult to make sure that he couldn't get it. But it looks like he's going for the red buff now. I'll just give it to him. I can maybe contest it, but it's still, he can just do the same thing over and over again. Hide behind the red buff, and my basic attacks won't be as much as his Eat Minion. So, yeah. As for tomorrow, by the way, I'll have another video of a god I haven't played that much. Also a hunter. I wanted to get a couple of hunters in with abilities, or not abilities, just hunters I haven't played too much in Season 3. Apollo is one of them. But the other one won't be ranked duel, though. He will be going for the Bull Demon King. He has Hand of the God, so I'll need to clear this as quickly as possible and head there immediately to try and contest it. Otherwise, he will have that free Phoenix push if I allow him to. Ooh, he actually destroyed that very quickly. Let's see, let's wait a little bit. I have my mass, so I can put him and position myself a little bit better. Did miss my so beautiful, my one. He will jump over the wall, so I'll get a couple of basic attacks in. He is so fast. He has the stone cutting sword, and the stone cutting sword is definitely very powerful. Come on, come on. Oh, nice, he missed one basic attack. That was everything I needed. He missed one basic attack. I think I missed one as well, but I guess that's an even trade. And that does allow me to... I think I'll get this Phoenix, actually. He's dead for 20 seconds. I do have a wave with me. So that means that I will be able to do a good amount of damage. I'm fully built, so I have a good amount of attack speed. Not a lot of penetration, though. So, yeah, 74 per hit. It's not too bad. And since I do have a lot of attack speed, I can definitely get this down. Because of my build, I don't get as much benefit from my passive. But I still feel like it's worth it because all the items I've gotten really are necessary. The Ick of All to box him, which I can get rid of now because Kins will do more for me at this stage. The Witchblade because of the protections and the attack speed reduction. Executioner to get rid of his protections, which are also important. And of course the Hastener to at least keep up with him as for mobility. I still want to fight him. I do have an entire fire wave, and he's tanking that fire wave very, very well. And he takes a lot of damage, and it will be enough. He died to the fire minions. One last shot of the fire creep will be enough. And this actually might be game. I do have a fire wave with me. It will take a little bit of time, but I can tank the Titan for a little bit. As I clear this wave, I will be at a good amount of health to tank the Titan for a bit. Use my Mesmerize to get some physical protection to make sure that I don't take as much damage. And I can just lead just to the fire creeps. And it looks like it's going to be it. That's going to be a victory. So that's how you beat that strong pick of a Bakasura. Be lucky to get Apollo. That time he actually gets the Bakasura. So I feel like I definitely had a good advantage. I think that from all the hunters, this might actually be the best counter to the Bakasura. Maybe the Hoyi, because Hoyi has that huge AoE where you can fight in. And of course that nice ricochet for that extreme amount of damage. You can see he did do more damage. I did have a lot of lifesteal, so I was able to sustain a decent amount. As you can see, he went for a lot of attack speed. He actually sold his boots in the end. I think he can get a guy, he can get away with it, but I feel like that if he kept his boots and instead of the Titan's Bane got Executioner, he would have been off a little bit better. Because getting Titan's Bane as well as Executioner kind of counteracts each other. Because it will first go for the Executioner reduction and then for the Titan's Bane. So you won't get as much out of your Titan's Bane. It's also both percentage, which, yeah, it doesn't... I mean, one time percentage is always better. If you have flat and you have percentage pen, you're good. You're well off. Executioner and the what's it called? The stone cutting sword is enough penetration for him to deal with me. If he got instead of the Titan's Bane, either Kins or just boots, I feel like he could have definitely won that fight because he can move so incredibly fast. Anyway, I'm glad I won this one. Like I said, tomorrow will be another Hunter. I haven't played in a long time. Not going to spoil it. You'll probably see it as the video goes up. I will be getting to the Season 4 as quickly as possible. But like I mentioned in my last video, I am having my internship at the moment. And that's taking up a lot of my time. I lose a lot of time on travel as well. And I do have my sport. I play sports a lot in the evening. So I'll see when I'll try to get it in. I mean, I did two videos for today as well. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. If you have any requests or any items you really want me to check out of Season 4, definitely leave them in the comments. Very curious to see. I've seen a couple of items. I'm not sure if they changed a lot since the PTS, but we'll have to see all about that and try to figure out what we want to build on every single god. Hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you guys so much for watching. And as always, good luck, have fun, and I'll see you guys in the next one.